Dolly, this is Louis. Dolly, it's so nice to have you back where you belong. You looking swell, Dolly. I can tell, Dolly. You still growing, you still growing, you still going strong. I feel the room swaying, but the band's playing one of our old favorite songs from way back when. So take a rap, fellas, find an empty lap, fellas. Dolly, never go away again.
July 4th, 1900 has long been reputed to be the day Louis Armstrong was born. That would be fitting for a man who did so much to shape American music in the 20th century, but it's too good to be true. Scholars have recently determined that the great musician Carl Satchmo was really born on August 4th, 1901. Louis Armstrong's biggest hit was Hello Dolly, released in 1964. The song, written by Jerry Herman, is one of NPR's 100 most important American musical works of the 20th century. Murray Horowitz has this appreciation.
When you talk to a great person at the end of a career, a doctor or a lawyer, a mother or a father, or if you hear a great coach talk about what it takes to win a championship, they'll say that after all the knowledge and all the skill, what it finally comes down to is character. It's true in music, too. The greatest performances go beyond virtuosity, beyond music even, to an assertion of humanity. And in 1964, there was a shining musical moment made almost purely by strength of character.
Hello, Dolly. This is Louis. Dolly, it's so nice to have you back where you belong. You looking swell, Dolly. I can tell, Dolly. You still growing, you still growing, you still going strong.
Louis Armstrong had not heard of the musical Hello Dolly before recording the title tune. It had been brought to him by a music publisher. The song itself is not a particularly high achievement. At the recording session in New York, December 4th, 1963, Armstrong expressed no great enthusiasm for it. But the songwriter, Jerry Herman, is a canny Broadway craftsman who knows how to write for stars. He gives great performers great opportunities. But he recently told NPR that even he had his doubts about Hello Dolly.
When a man from my publishing company called me and said, Louis Armstrong wants to record that, I laughed. I thought it was the silliest idea that I had ever heard. But I said, let him have a good time. I'm delighted, you know. And when I heard the recording, I fell out of my chair because he turned my 1890s Valentine into one of the most famous pop songs of all time.
How did he do it? The song sounds predictable. In fact, it bears such a striking similarity to a 1949 tune by Mac David, Sunflower, that David sued for plagiarism and got an out-of-court settlement. The treatment of the song is, well, a little corny. There's that banjo, and what's that string section doing there? But as the trumpeter and composer Wynton Marsalis has said, in everything he ever recorded, there comes a point where Louis Armstrong let you know that he was Louis Armstrong. On one level, that point comes right at the beginning, when the maestro sings, "This is Louis Dolly." But for me, the moment is a purely musical one at the end of the first 8 measures of his trumpet solo. First of all, it's a terrific solo, hard swinging, as Armstrong's always are. But there's this little phrase at the end of the opening, I won't do it justice, something like, da 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 da. Check it out. It's that individual stamp, that celebration of freedom and joy that Armstrong tried to put into everything. And it never came out stronger than in Hello, Dolly. Arvel Shaw was Armstrong's bassist for over 20 years, including the Hello, Dolly session. He says Armstrong was so unimpressed by the tune, he forgot about it. Famously, he seldom listened to the radio, preferring the tapes that he carried with him everywhere. In the winter of 1964, in concerts in Iowa and Nebraska, people in the audience began to shout for Hello, Dolly. For a few nights, Armstrong ignored them. Finally, he turned to Arvel Shaw one night and asked, "What's Hello, Dolly?" "Well, you know, Pops, it's that tune we recorded." Armstrong called New York for the sheet music. A rehearsal was held. That night, Louis Armstrong and the All-Stars played Hello, Dolly, and the crowd went wild. By May, the record had incredibly pushed the Beatles out of the number one spot on the Billboard Top 40 for the first time in over 3 months. And at age 63, Louis Armstrong had become the oldest person ever to have a number one hit record.
I feel the room sway while the band's playing one of our old favorite songs from way back when. So take a rap, fellas, find an empty lap, fellas, Dolly, never go away again.
I asked Arvel Shaw why. He said, "I've been trying to figure that out for 40 years. If somebody could write a book about what made Hello, Dolly a hit, they'd make a fortune." My answer? Louis Armstrong, pure and simple. The force of his personality, his irresistible humanity. Well, Arvel's not entirely sure about that. He thinks it also had something to do with the timing of a big Broadway hit show and the release of the title tune by a big star. But as he talked, he agreed. Nobody else could have taken that song and made it a hit. Louis Armstrong played for audiences all over the world, for millions in Africa, Asia, Europe, Latin America, and for kids eating ice cream on his front porch in Queens. And everywhere he went, audiences responded to him the same way. It used to puzzle me. Musicians have told me it's impossible that all those people really understood his music. What they must have responded to was his spirit, his integrity, and his life force. What they understood was Louis.
Murray Horowitz is a playwright, lyricist, and vice president of NPR's cultural programming.
I feel the room sway, but the band's playing one of our old favorite songs from way back when. So, Dolly G, fellas, have a little faith in me, fellas. Dolly, never go away.